boxing. This isn't MMA, my friend. And you can't learn how to box in 86 days. And that will show in the ring. The Disney kid is going to beat up the five-time UFC champion of the world, the Hall of Famer, and it's going to be hilarious.
You're going to catch him and drop him?
You need a better player to show what you can do. So that means you're going to show us more of what you can do against a better player.
Exactly. I haven't even shown my fighting abilities at all. I haven't even made it past two rounds in my professional career. I haven't been hit in the face. No one can even see if I got a chin. No one can see my inside fighting game. I haven't even gotten warmed up. And by the way, I'm the type of fighter that gets better in the third, fourth, fifth, sixth, seventh round. I get better in sparring. And so I really haven't even been able to warm up, lace up, get hit. Like, I'm excited to really show all my ability. If he can even make it out of the first round. I was training today, and I swear to God, like, I think by now people have to see, like, I don't care. I predicted every single one of my fights. I said Ben Askren first round. I said Nate Robinson first round. He got to the second. I said my first pro fight first round. I don't think Tyrone can make it out of two rounds, so you might not even see my boxing ability in this fight, to be honest.
Why does he lost two if the others could only last one?
I think he's going to be in shape. I think he's a little bit more athletic. He is a five-time UFC champion. He's got knockout power. I see it in him. He's going to be training hard for this. I think harder than Ben Askren by far. And so he's going to come in good shape. So he might be able to take a couple more punches than Ben did.
Percentage-wise, how much more money is he making for this fight than he did for his UFC fights?
A lot. Like hundreds of percentages. I can't even do the math.
Jake, boxer or not, it's pretty crazy that you're a guy that's a social media guy. Now you're fighting real fighters, like just like that.
Yeah. What was the question?
Sorry. Oh, you're right. That was my question. So, you're a social media star. Now you come over to fighting, and like, boom, just like that, you're fighting, you know, top UFC guys. That sounds like a lot of balls and a lot of dedication, though.
100%. But I love it. I'm passionate about it. And look, we've been working in the dark to shine in the light. I've been doing this for 4 years now, and I don't know. I just got, God gave me power, speed, and I believe I was put on this earth to box, as crazy as that sounds. And I found my home, I found my calling, and I have the best team. I have the best coaches, and they don't let me do one single thing wrong in training and practice. EJ Flores, Jacob Chavez, Jay Leon Love, D-Cut, E-Bach, the whole entire team is just on 10. And so you need that. And a lot of these guys will, you know, hire some random coaches for their camps or switch up their coaches every 3-4 years and try and learn something new. We got a game plan, we stick to the fundamentals, and we knock people out.
Do you have plans?
We have a tremendous outfit on right now. We have Mickey and Minnie here driving around,
sponsor,
having a picnic,
the
Mickey
shoes,
bag,
the shoes,
yes, sir. Yes, sir.
The watch. I'm assuming this is an ode to Tyron calling you a Disney star, and that's it.
100%. I'm wearing Disney because he's going to get knocked out by a Disney star. And look, Bizarre Bark, which is the Disney show that I was on, created the biggest prize fighter in the world, Jake Paul, and created the biggest musical star in the world, Olivia Rodrigo. So there was something in the air on that set, but I don't even know what happened, but it created two of the biggest stars in the world.
Do you have plans past Tyron, or are you just focused on him right now?
I'm going for McGregor. I'm going for Mayweather. I'm going for all of these guys. I want Kamaru Usman, Diaz. I got a long list, you know, but I'm not looking past Tyron at all. I have to take him out. I have to take him out first.
Is it true there were other names? We heard maybe Michael Bisping was offered a fight.
That was prior to Askren.
Yeah, I mean, there was a lot of names. It's like who was available. These guys are all owned by Dana White. So who is Dana White going to let out of his contract to get knocked out?
Let me ask you this. You've been outspoken about Dana White in the UFC. What does it say that Tyron Woodley, who's a champion, a former champion of the UFC, is likely going to make his biggest purse fighting you in another sport and, you know, against, with all due respect, someone that comes from the entertainment industry?
I think there's a movement moving forward that is going to show that fighters should be getting paid more. It's unfair that the UFC fighters don't have fair pay. Out of all the sports, the percentage that the owners get versus the athletes, they're the lowest. Francis Ngannou versus John Jones, that fight should happen. Dana White, pay them the $10 million. He's taking their money. They're the ones making the content. They're the ones getting in the ring, risking their life. Chris Weidman goes in, snaps his leg in half. What's that look like? He may never be able to fight again and provide food for his family. These fighters are risking their lives. You can quite literally die in the ring, and they need to be compensated more. And I'm a big proponent of that movement and being in control. And just like music labels, same thing. These artists are getting owned, and they get locked up into these shitty contracts, and they don't know what to do. So fuck that shit. Fuck Dana White.
What does it say that you're the most outspoken person for UFC fighter pay, and you're not even in the UFC?
Because no one else can talk shit to Dana, because he'll just sideline them, and then they're fucked. I'm the only only one that doesn't need Dana White in the fight world. Everyone else is scared of him. I don't give a fuck about him.
Do you believe you'll see more UFC fighters fight out their contract so they can fight you rather than fight the UFC?
100%. I think there's going to be a change of movement. We're innovating the fight game, and you're starting to see that, you know, this is a show business. A lot of people like to focus just on the sport aspect of it, but it's all the way around. You're going to see fighters start to post content more. You're going to see fighters start to talk shit to people more. And, you know, this is just the start of something massive.